Becoming a gray man is all about concealing your true nature and abilities. Present yourself as an average, unremarkable person so that others do not perceive you as a threat. This helps you move through life unnoticed and gives you freedom to observe and manipulate from the shadows. The first thing you need to do is take a hard look at yourself. What makes you stand out? Is it your clothes, your haircut, your posture? Identify those things and change them. Dress in dark, neutral clothing. Keep your hair short and simple. Stand up straight, but don't draw attention to yourself. Control your presence. Minimize eye contact. And do not draw attention to yourself in gatherings. Speak rarely and in a quiet, unassuming voice. Always deflect the focus onto other people rather than talking about yourself. Respond honestly, but give only the bare minimum details needed. The less others know about you, the better. The second step is to limit your actions. Do not initiate conversations or participate in group discussions unless absolutely necessary. Always stay on the periphery. Complete tasks efficiently and quietly without drawing attention to your process or results. Be helpful to others, but do not seek praise or acknowledgement for your contributions. Here's an example of a situation where being a gray man would be useful. You are sitting in your high school cafeteria, quietly observing the social dynamics among your classmates. A group of popular kids sits at a nearby table, laughing loudly and drawing attention. You notice that one of the most popular girls has dropped her expensive-looking bracelet on the floor. If you were not a gray man, you might instinctively pick up the bracelet to return it, seeking gratitude and social points with the popular group. However, this draws their attention to you. Gossip starts to spread, rumors form, and now you become a target of their scrutiny and judgment. But being a practiced gray man, you notice the bracelet and leave it on the floor. You continue eating your lunch, blending into the background. Eventually, one of the popular kids spots the bracelet and returns it to its owner. The group's attention moves on. They forget about you, and you remain safely invisible. After school, you can analyze what you observed during lunch without any external pressures or biases. The social experiment plays out in your mind freely, and you gain insight that you would not have if you had inserted yourself into the situation. Being a gray man gives you this freedom of detached observation and unimpeded thought. So in this minor scenario, being a gray man allowed you to glean information and insights from others while avoiding the potential social complications that direct interaction may have brought. The ability to pass unnoticed through environments can be quite valuable. The final step is perfecting your poker face. Master a polite, pleasant expression that reveals nothing of your thoughts or emotions. Develop an insincere smile that you can flash automatically without it reaching your eyes. This will prevent others from interpreting your true reactions and intentions. Follow these steps, and you will slowly fade into the background of every environment. People will forget you are there, allowing you to observe and strategize in peace. You will become invisible, free to make your next move without interference. Now go practice. The best gray men hide in plain sight. Remember, being a gray man is not about being a hero or standing out. It's about being able to move through the world unnoticed. It takes practice and discipline, but with time and dedication, you too can become invisible. They don't see me coming. I learned long ago how to fade into the shadows and observe without being observed. It served me well over the years, allowing me to gather intel and exploit vulnerabilities without raising alarms. People forget I'm in the room and they say things they shouldn't. I record everything on my laptop and file it all away for future use. Dressing like this helps. All black, combat boots, face devoid of makeup. My piercings and tattoos are normally on display as a warning, but I cover them up when I want to blend in. People see a skinny punk girl and dismiss me, forgetting that still waters run deep. My boots are steel-toed in case I need to make a quick exit. Eye contact makes them uncomfortable, so I don't bother. Just stare at my computer screen as I hack their systems right under their nose. They never notice, too busy flapping their gums. Half the time they've forgotten my name by the time the meeting ends. It doesn't matter, though, because I know everything about them, while they know nothing about me. I cracked their encrypted files and wiretapped their calls without breaking a sweat. Now I sit back and watch the fireworks as their secrets are exposed, all without them realizing I was the one pulling the strings. They'll never see my face or connect the dots back to me. As far as they're concerned, it was just bad luck, but I make my own luck in this world. Being invisible is the ultimate advantage, and it's paid off time and again. So let them keep underestimating the mousy girl in the corner. It will be their downfall, not mine. I'm the spider in their web, and they never even knew I was there until it was too late.